Tzitzit Sanhedrin, page 86, we'll start with the Mishnah, page 85b, 15 lines from the bottom of the page. Hagunev nefesh miYisrael eno chayav ad sheyachnisenu lirshuto. Here we talk about abducting a Jewish person. Obviously, the example that comes right away in our minds is the story of Yosef ve'echav, the biblical Joseph and his brothers. Obviously, there is a lot of explanation, like the Chiddush HaArim, who said that they didn't put Hasmachat Yadayim on him, the Torat Moshe Alshich, and others that bring a different light for the story. But in general, this is the law of Gneivat Nefesh, meaning stealing a person, a soul, and we're going to deal with the consequences, because it can be someone who's stealing a pregnant woman for the sake of her baby, or stealing someone who's at the state of sleeping, or someone who's stealing his son in order those days to sell him in the slave market and more. So anyway, the Mishnah said, one who abducts a Jewish person is not liable to be executed. No chayav, he doesn't have the chenek, strangulation. Ad sheyachnisenu lirshuto. So the Gemara in Ketubot, page 30b, explained to us that bringing to a person's domain, it doesn't, unlike money, that the moment you steal it, it's stolen. Here, if you have the kinyan meshicha, it's a pooling, needs to take it to his domain. The Torah said in the book of Shemot, chapter 21, וגונב איש ומחרו, if a person abducts another person, ונמצא בידו, בידו meaning in his domain. רבי יהודה אומר, עד שהכניסנו לרשותו והשתמש בו, רבי יהודה add another condition, it's not enough that he take it, bring it into his domain, but he also exploit him. He bring the source, this שנאמר, the Torah said in the book of Dvarim, chapter 24, כי ימצא איש גונב נפש מאחד בני ישראל, ויתאמר בו ומחרו. So they used the word exploited him and sold him. So again, the chiyuv, the obligation, is as long as he's not exploited, use it. That's the framework of obligations. Hagonevet bno, that will be someone steal his son, obviously those days, as we said, in order to sell him. Rabbi Shmuel bno shel Rabbi Yochanan ben Broka mechayev, obligated to give chenek. Vachachamim potrim, obviously we need to know what's involved. עדים והתראה אל מור, the Gemara elaborates later. גנב מי שחציו עבד וחציו בן חורין. So if, for example, you have a slave in those days that have two owners, so if someone takes someone who's a half slave and half a free man, which is taken in those days, it was Knanite slave, so they used to belong to two owners and was a can be free by one of them, yet the other one owns him, רבי יהודה מחייב וחמים פותרים, and we explain later why. Rabbi Yehuda make him deem him liable versus the sages said not. So the Gemara asks, "V'tana kama lo ba'ei imu?" The first Tana not acquire exploitation as the condition for liability. So the Gemara said, "Amarav chavred Rava imu pachut mishave pruta ikabenayu." So here we talk about exploitation with less than value of the pruta. Ba'ei Rabbi Yirmiyahu agnavo mecharo yashen ma'u. So here we talk about one who abducts a person while he is in a state of sleep. Machal isha le'ubara. So again, someone abducted a woman, not for her, but he wants solely to benefit from the fetus. Mao, yesh derech imu b'chach, or en derech imu b'chach? You mean to say that you have a manner of exploitation with this or not? So obviously the difference is that if yes, then it's a matter of execution, it's a punishment. So the tepuklei delika imur klal can say that the abductor is not liable because there's no exploitation, that all person is sleeping in the world or an individual or fetus. So they said, lo tzricha, yashen dizga alei, one is sleeping with a real recline on him, and when it's come to a pregnant woman, isha de ukma be'apei zika, that she would stand in the face of the wind to protect himself from the wind. because you have a large belly. דרחימו בחח או אין דרחימו בחח מאי תקו. So he said, is that matter of exploitation not, and left it unresolved. תנו רבנן, כי מצא איש גונב נפש מאחיו, אין לי אלא איש שגנב אישה מניין, since it was spelled out the word איש, תלמוד לומר וגונב איש, meaning even woman, אין לי אלא איש שגנב, I understand that it's a man's stole, בין אישה ובין איש, וכן אישה שגנבה איש, אישה שגנבה אישה מניין, all of that I understand, but how about if woman abduct another woman? תלמוד לומר, הוא מת הגנב ההוא מכל מקום, because the Torah said that abductor shall die, so we derive from that, that it's any case, regardless of the sex of the one who was abducted. תניא אידך, כי מצא איש גונב נפש מאחיו, אחד הגונב את האיש ואחד הגונב את האישה, ואחד גר ואחד עובד משוחרר וקטן חייו. So it's no matter what, it's all different of abduction, it's all liable. גנבו ולא מחרו, if he stole, but he's still not sold, מחרו ועדיין ישנו ברשותו, even he sold it, but he's still in his domain, פטור, so this is exempt. So this is a Ramban and Tosfot, dealing a lot with the מעשה קניין, how far you consider that as a formal act of selling. The Minchat Chinuch, chapter 36, elaborates when exactly is a matter of transactions and sell and when is not. מחרו לאביו ולאחיו, או לאחד מן הקרובים. So if the abduct, they sold to the father of the abductee, or the brother, or one of his other relatives, the abductor is liable, חייב, הגונב את העבדים פטור, one who abducts slaves, he is exempt, and obviously Rashi said that that's the word ha-hu, it's דווקא מיעוט, that's the idea, מבני ישראל, according to Rabbanan, according to Rabbi Yehuda, from the word Echav, and the Rashash elaborates, you see the Rambam, in Chol Gnevat chapter 9, the Rambam said, one who abducts a slave, even if the abductee is half slave, half free man, is exempt from liability, that's basically follow the Braita, follow the Mishnah. 86, Tanei Tana, Kamei de Rav Sheshet. So here we have this Amora that used to stand and teach the Braitot before Rav Sheshet. So the whole idea that a person's stole, abducted the person and sold it to the father of the that person. So he said, Amar lei ani shone Rabbi Shimon omer me'echav. Rabbi Shimon said the pasuk in Dvarim 24 speak of his brother. So it means that there is no liability unless he removes the abductee from the domain of his brother. עד שיציאנו מרשות אחיו. It's only if he separate the abductee from his family. ואת אמרת חייב. So that's basically contradicted the brighter that I said. You tell me that that you holding that one who sells the abductee to his father is liable. So תנאי פטור. So the Braita teaches that instead it's exempt. Mai kushya. What exactly the question, the difficulty that Rav Sheshet taught from Rabbi Shimon? Dilma ha Rabbi Shimon. It may be that that's for Rabbi Shimon. The ha and the brother that teach the previous Amora, that follow Rabbanan, the sages, and is a Tanaic disputation, and you do not need to change the girsa in the brayta. So the Gemara answered and said, Lo sal kadatach, you cannot say it. Doma Rabbi Yochanan, stamei Rabbi Mei, stamishna Rabbi Mei, so Rabbi Yehuda Hanasii that put in order the whole Mishnah Yod, he brought many different Tanaim. So in general, we say that any time that we have in the Mishnah general halakha without specification, we learn that that's follow Rabbi Meir, stam tosefta. So tosefta, that's the collection of the Braitot that came in addition to the Mishnah. So the Rabbi Nehemiah, stam sifra Rabbi Yehuda, when you have an attribute to Braita in the sifra, the halachic midrash of the book of the Leviticus, so they follow the view of Rabbi Yehuda. Stam sifrei, so the book that they have unattributed, sifrei, that's basically the books of Numbers and Deuteronomy, Rabbi Shimon. So according to Rabbeinu Hananel, Tractate Yuma 40b, so that applies to the word sifrei, that it's a plural, two books, versus sifra, singular, that's only Leviticus. Vechulho, and all of these follow the view, aliba de Rabbi Akiva. So all go by Rabbi Akiva. Everyone follow what they learn from him. So there is a book called Tiferet Shlomo. In Tiferet Shlomo, on Parashat Bereishit, he explained, based on the Gemara in Brachot 63b, that we learned that Rabbi Akiva, Masar Nafsho, he devoted his life, he was one of the 10 martyrs, and because he did it, he reached that highest level. All his life he said, Matai, when I reach this point, and I fulfill it, that's the famous story of his horrible death as one of the 10 martyrs. So that's basically the, in a way, the reward. Hagonev bno. So Rabbi Shmuel, the son of Rabbi Yochanan ben Broka, said that he's liable, said he's exempt him. Mai ta'amah de Rabbanan, Amar Abaye de Amar Kra ki imatze. When the Torah speaks in Deuteronomy 24 about Gonev Nefesh, the Torah used the word ki imatze, prat le matzui, which is the son of the thief. Amar le Rav Papa le Abaye, ela me'ata ki imatze yishuchav im isha bulat ba'al. When the Torah said that we found a man who's lying with a married, one married woman, that her husband, Hachanami ki imatze prat le matzui. So it's also here, you can say that ki imatze, that if a man should found to exclude one who was already found, kigon shel beit ploni de shchichan gabay. There's certain houses that get used to be together with married women. So you see where the married women are commonly found and they have a pre-existing reputation for being such a immoral behavior. Amar le, Abaye said, Ana mi venimtza beyado ka'amina. I derive from Shmot 21 from Exodus that the Pasuk said, or if he is found in the possession, he shall be put to death. So it means that I derive from that, prat le matzui, that's otherwise the pasuk is superfluous. Amar Rava Hilkach, hanei mikrei dardarkei umatnu rabanan, those who teach young children, kimtzuyin biyadam damu uftirei. So if they steal from one of the students, there will be exam. So he said, Ganav misha chetzio. If someone, the Mishnah says, if someone steals someone who is a half free and half slave. So Rabbi Yehuda said that they deem him liable, they say just exempt him. Tanatan, learn Bava Kama 87. Rabbi Yehuda omer en la'avadim boshet. So all the five type of compensation, when it's come to boshet, when it's come to humiliation, that's not applied to slave, Rabbi Yehuda said. Ma'i tamad Rabbi Yehuda, amar kach ki natzu anashim yechdav ish ve'achiv mishesh lo achva. It's a Eved she'en lo achva. So the Eved doesn't have the halachically rules of a family. Verabanan, achivu b'mitzvot. He's the same obligated with mitzvot as woman. You need to duck in the shem of dut, etc. והכה, היכה דרש רבי יהודה, סבר מאחיו להפוק העבדים, בני ישראל למהותם משחציו אבן וחציו בן חורין, מבני ישראל למהותם משחציו אבן וחציו בן חורין, have a מיעוט אחר מיעוט. You have here restriction follow restrictions, and he said ben מיעוט אחר מיעוט על לרבות. So basically you have restriction after restrictions. He's come to teach us to amplify the halakha and to include in the category of those who are liable, one who abducts, one who is half slave, half free man. ורבנן, how the sages derive, מאחיו לאפוקי עבדים למשמו להו, דהה אחיו במצוות בני ישראל, מבני ישראל, from this word of the children of Israel, the expression, have two different purposes, אחד לימוד העבד, one serves to exclude from liability, one abduct slaves, וחלמות המשחצי עובד וחצי עובד אחרים. One to exclude, one is a half free and half slave. אז הרע לגונב נפש מניים, we have this prohibition against abducting a person before your wife. רבי יושעי אמר, מילות תגנוב, should not steal, we explained many times that these are two different categories. One is לא תגנוב, one is לא תגנובו. לא תגנוב, do not steal, that's גונב נפשות, that's human. רבי יוחנן אמר, that's דבר למד בניינו. רבי יוחנן אמר, מי מכרו במכרת עבד, ולא פליגי אמר, כחשיב לאו דגנבה, אמר, דכחשיב לאו דמכירה. One will have the prohibition against abduction, the other one have the prohibition against selling the abductee into slavery. תנו רבנן לא תגנוב, גונב נפשות, רגע הוא מדבר. אתה אומר גונב נפשות, עונה עליו גונב ממון. It's a common mistake that people think that that applies to money. אמר צה אומן משלוש עמדות שאותו אנדרש בהם, the 13 principles that רבן גמליאל teach us. דבר הלמד בעניינו במה הדבור וכתוב מדבר. What exactly the sun method that derived from its context, since the whole context speak about what? אנוכי השם לא יהיה לך, לא צלו, אצלו, all this commandment, לא תרצח, לא תנאף, all this speak about capital punishment. So במה הכתוב נראה מנפשות, אף כאן בנפשות, capital case of abduction. תניידה לא תגנובו, ולראה מלוויליקוס with וו, יושנת סטיל, לוויליקוס 19, בגונב ממון הכתוב מדבר, אתה מגונב ממון או למה מגונב מנפשות, maybe someone who steal soul, אמרת הצלול מה משלוש עמדות רן דרש בהם, the same way, דבר למין ללא, ממה הכתוב מדבר, וממון אף כאן ממון, because the context, it's all in לוויליקוס speaks about monetary, someone who should pay his employee the same day, it's all this concept of הלכי כנבר with money, so therefore this is one of them. איתמר, ידי גניבה וידי מכירה בנפש שהוזנו. חזקי אמר נהרגים, רבי יוחנן אמר נהרגים. חזקי אדם אמר כרבי עקיבא, אדם אמר דבר ולא חצי דבר, רבי יוחנן אמר כרבן אדם אמר דבר ואפילו חצי דבר. ומודה חזקי הבדים האחרונים של בן צורר ומורה שהוזנו שנהרגים, מתוך שיכולים לומר על הראשונים, 86 בילן כותו בנו והנחרינה כולי דבר כאב דילי. מתקיף לרב פאפה יחי ידי מכירה נאמן לקטלי, so you also those witnesses that come and for sale one was abducted מתוך שיכולים מדי גניבה לומר על כותו בנו because the witnesses that come to the sale so they said that we came here to flag him the abductor not to execute him so וחיתם עד כסבר חזקיה דלא לקי. So you hold that חזקיה said that the one who abducts another is not selling, is not flagged, it's hard to say. והאית מרדי גניבה בנפש שהוזמו חזקיה ורבי יוחנן, אחד אמר לוקים, אחד אמר אלוקים. והאווין התסתיים בחזקיה, אמר לוקים, אמר חזקיה, אין נרגין. די רבי יוחנן, כיוון אמר נרגין, אבל אליו שניתן לזרד מיטת בית דין. וכוליו שניתן לעזרת בית דין אין לוקים עליו, יהיו לו לה, כי אינו לך, יחל לקו. אלא אומר רב פאפה בידי מכירת כולם עלו פליגי דין הרגים, כי פליגי בידי גניבה. חזקי אמר אין הרגים גניבה לחודה קיימה, ומכירה לחודה קיימה, רבי יוחנן אמר נרגים גניבה, התחלת את המכירה היא. You know that they get executed because the beginning of the abduction is the beginning of the process that culminates with the sale. So the witnesses testifying that to the abduction are testifying to the transgression that will culminate the sale of the abductee. מודה רבי יוחנן בעדים הראשונים של בן צורי ומורה שהוזמו שאין נרגים מדוח שיכולים לומר, מתוך שיכולים לומר להלקותו בנו, אומר רבי, הכל מודים מבן צורי ומורה, והכל מודים מבן צורי ומורה, ומחלוקת בן צורי ומורה. הכל מודים בן צורי ומורה בעדים הראשונים שאין נרגים מתוך שיכולים לומר להלקותו בנו. והכל מודים בן צורי ומורה בעדים האחרונים שאין נרגים מתוך שדים הראשונים יכולים לומר להלקותו בנו, ועל כל הדבר כאבדלי. ומחלוקת בן צורי ומורה, שניים אומרים בפנינו גנב, שניים אומרים בפנינו אכל. אומר רבי אסי, ידי מכירה בנפש שהוזמו הנרגים, מתוך שיכול לומר עבדים אחרתי. אומר רבי יוסף, כמן האזלה. השמדה דרבי אסי, כרבי עקיבא, דאמר דבר ולא חצי דבר. אמר לאביי, אי כרבנן. נרגים מתוך כמה, להפיד לוטים הרבנן, ובדלה אתו ידי גניבה. יחי מי לממרה, לא צריך הדף על גב, דעת הוא לבסוף. והקטי מי לממרה, לא צריך ה... דקמרם זה רימוזי. One cut of aidim give a implied gesture to the other. מהו לתם הרמיז המלטאי? כמה שמענו רמיז עליו כלומי. Gesturing is not... nothing significant.